A very good morning. You're watching the breakfast news on Rajya Sabha television. It is Monday morning and lots making news. I'm Ashwarya Kapoor. Let us start the news bulletin with the headlines. Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu to lay foundation stone for the construction of Kartarpur corridor in Gurdaspur in Punjab. Corridor to allow Sikh pilgrims easy passage to Gurudwara Darbar Sahib in Pakistan. Two union ministers to attend groundbreaking ceremony of the corridor in Pakistan on Wednesday. Pakistan welcomes move. Nation marks the 10th anniversary of the Mumbai terror attacks. President Ramnath Kovind remembers victims and heroes of the tragedy. Says India remains honor-bound to securing justice and defeating terrorism. US announces $5 million reward for information on 26/11 perpetrators. Last day of campaigning today for Madhya Pradesh and Mizoram Assembly elections. Prime Minister Modi and Congress President Rahul Gandhi to campaign in Rajasthan. Election Commission lowers a daily cash transaction limit of candidates to 10,000 rupees for campaigning. Constitution Day being observed today to mark the adoption of Indian Constitution by the Constituent Assembly in 1949. Vice President says, must have trust and honour in constitutional bodies and processes. Attends dinner hosted by Chief Justice of India along with Prime Minister Modi on the eve of the occasion. And Harmanpreet Kaur named captain of the ICC Women's World T20 11. Opener Smriti Mandhana and leg spinner Poonam Yadav also picked by ICC selection panel in Dubai. The biggest story this Monday morning, Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu and Punjab Chief Minister Captain Amarinder Singh will jointly lay the foundation stone for the Dera Baba Nanak ka Kartarpur Sahib corridor on the Indian side today. Remember last week, the Union Cabinet had cleared a proposal for building the Kartarpur corridor to provide easy passage to Sikh pilgrims to the historic Gurudwara in Pakistan. The government will build the corridor from Dera Baba Nanak in Punjab's Gurdaspur district to the international border to facilitate Sikh pilgrims from India to visit Kartarpur Sahib Gurudwara, which is located about 3 kilometers from the Indo-Pak border in Pakistan. Meanwhile, Pakistan has welcomed India's decision to send two union ministers to attend the groundbreaking ceremony of the Kartarpur, calling it a positive response. Union Ministers Harsimrat Kaur Badal and Hardeep Singh Puri and Congress leader Navjot Singh Sidhu will travel to Pakistan to attend the event on Wednesday. Pakistan's invitation was declined by External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj and Punjab Chief Minister Captain Amarinder Singh. Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan will inaugurate the groundbreaking ceremony of the Kartarpur corridor on the Pakistani side on 28th of November. And now let's bring you all the news and updates from the 5 election-bound states. The Election Commission has lowered the limit of cash transactions by candidates for campaigning purposes from 20,000 rupees to 10,000 rupees per day. Now, this is a bid by the poll body to check the flow of excess money in electioneering. For transactions beyond 10,000 rupees, candidates and parties will have to make payment using cross-checks, drafts or electronic means, including NEFT, through the account of the candidate open for electioneering. Now, a candidate cannot receive a donation or loan in cash in excess of 10,000 rupees from a single person or any entity during campaigning. The election watchdog has been pushing for greater transparency in election-related expenditure by parties and candidates. And news from Madhya Pradesh and Mizoram, because today is the last day for campaigning in both the states. The two states go to polls on 28th of November, that is on Wednesday. In Madhya Pradesh, a single phase voting will be held for 230 seats of the assembly. The BJP government under Shivraj Singh Chauhan is looking to retain power in the state, and the Congress is trying to make a comeback into the state after staying out of power for 15 years. And in Mizoram, single-phase polling will be held for the 40-member assembly on Wednesday. The Congress government has been in power in the state since 2008. Chief Minister Lal Thanola has said that the Congress is open to form a post-poll alliance with like-minded parties, excluding the BJP and MNF, if the ruling party falls short of majority. He, however, has claimed that such a situation will not arise, as the Congress will get a full majority on its own. And Prime Minister Narendra Modi campaigned in Madhya Pradesh on Sunday. And defending BJP's rule in the state of Madhya Pradesh, Prime Minister Narendra Modi asked people in Vidisha and Jabalpur to compare what he called 55 years of Congress's misrule with 15 years of the BJP rule in the state. In Vidisha, he said that the Shivraj Singh government has brought in most comprehensive crop insurance scheme. He said the farmers have immensely benefited from it. He said under Pradhan Mantri Grameen Sarak Yojana, 16,000 settlements in Madhya Pradesh have been connected by road. The Prime Minister also criticized Congress leaders for making personal attacks on him. He targeted the party for dragging his parents into a political slugfest.
पिछले दिनों कांग्रेस पार्टी ने जो बयानबाजी की है वो इस बात का सबूत है कि न सिर्फ उन्होंने जनता से विश्वास खोया है, खुद पर से भी विश्वास उन्होंने खो दिया है। अब उनको लगता है कि विकास के मुद्दे पर भाजपा और शिवराज जी की सरकार का कोई मुकाबला नहीं है। विकास के मुद्दे पर जब मोदी चुनौती देता है कि आपकी चार पीढ़ी और चाय वाले के चार साल, बहुत दिक्कत होती है उनको। जब मुद्दे नहीं बचे हैं, तर्क नहीं बचे हैं, जिनका जनता का विश्वास खो चुके हैं, खुद कर पा भरोसा उठ गया है, तो एक ही रास्ता बचा, गाली गलौज।
And Prime Minister Modi will be campaigning in Rajasthan today. His rallies will be in Bhilwara, Kota and Bandeshwar Dham. Now, the 200-member Rajasthan Assembly goes to polls on 7th of December. On Sunday, he campaigned in Alwar. The Prime Minister said that those attacking the BJP are doing so because they are unable to give an explanation to the people for the amount of work they did when they were in power in the state.
हर कोई नागरिक एक ही मंत्र लेकर के इस चुनाव को देख रहा है और वो मंत्र है विकास कैसा होगा, विकास कौन करेगा, और हर कोई पिछली सरकारों को याद करके भारतीय जनता पार्टी की विकास यात्रा को कोटि कोटि आशीर्वाद दे रहे हैं। कांग्रेस पार्टी में हिम्मत हो तो वसुंधरा जी ने अपने कार्यकाल में जो काम किया है, वसुंधरा जी जो दावे कर रही है, अरे जरा उसको चुनौती देकर के मैदान में आओ ना। लेकिन उनके पिछली सरकार के 5 साल का हिसाब इतना बुरा है कि वसुंधरा जी के 5 साल के कामों को याद करने की भी इनकी हिम्मत नहीं है.
And as campaigning heats up in poll-bound states, Congress President Rahul Gandhi will address election rallies in Rajasthan today. Rahul Gandhi will begin the tour of the state by offering prayers at Ajmer Sharif Dargah, followed by a visit to Pushkar Sarovar. After that, he will leave for Pokhran in Jaisalmer, where he will address a public meeting. Rahul Gandhi will be accompanied with the former Chief Minister Ashok Gehlot and Congress leader Sachin Pilot. Indeed, campaigning is in full swing ahead of the assembly elections and addressing election rallies in poll-bound Telangana. BJP chief Amit Shah accused the Telangana government led by K. Chandrasekhar Rao for failing to keep its promises and claimed that only the BJP under the leadership of Prime Minister Narendra Modi can ensure the state's development. Amit Shah said the BJP-led government launched the Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana for providing health insurance cover, but KCR did not implement the scheme as he's afraid of Modi's popularity.
Bharatiya Janata Party ki sarkar ne Ayushman Bharat Yojana lai, jiske tahat har garib ko 5 lakh tak ka kharcha, har prakar ka kharcha. हॉस्पिटलाइजेशन ऑपरेशन ऑपरेशन के बाद का हॉस्पिटलाइजेशन दवाइयां टेस्ट हर खर्चे को भारतीय जनता पार्टी की केंद्र सरकार देने वाली है. मगर मोदी जी लोकप्रिय हो जाएंगे ये डर से ये तेलंगाना सरकार ने यहां पर आयुष्मान भारत योजना को स्वीकारा नहीं है. मैं तेलंगाना वासियों को कहना चाहता हूं ये आपके साथ अन्याय.
Prime Minister Modi addressed the 50th episode of his monthly radio program Mann Ki Baat on Sunday, and he said the show is neither about him, politics or the government. He said that he has upheld India's unity and culture above politics in the program.
Kuch yuva mitron ne Mann Ki Baat mein aaye sab vishayon par ek study ki. Unhone sare episode ka लेक्सिकल एनालिसिस किया और उन्होंने अध्ययन किया कि कौन से शब्द कितनी बार बोले गए, कौन से शब्द हैं जो बार बार बोले गए. उनकी एक फाइंडिंग यही है कि यह कार्यक्रम अपॉलिटिकल रहा. जब मन की बात शुरू किया था तभी मैंने तय किया था कि ना इसमें पॉलिटिक्स हो, ना इसमें सरकार की वाहवाही हो, ना इसमें कहीं मोदी हो. और मेरे इस संकल्प को निभाने के लिए सबसे बड़ा संबल, सबसे बड़ी प्रेरणा मिली आप सबसे. हर मन की बात से पहले आने वाले पत्रों, ऑनलाइन कमेंट्स, फोन कॉल्स, इनमें श्रोताओं की अपेक्षाएं साफ होती हैं. मोदी आएगा और चला जाएगा, लेकिन यह देश अटल रहेगा, हमारी संस्कृति अमर रहेगी. 130 करोड़ देशवासियों की छोटी छोटी यह कहानियां हमेशा जीवित रहेगी. इस देश को नई प्रेरणा, नए उत्साह से नई ऊंचाइयों पर लेती जाती रहेगी.
The Prime Minister also dwelled at length about why he chose radio as a medium for connecting with the people, saying that it was a mighty means of getting across to the people. He said that the expectations and aspirations of listeners through their letters and online comments helped shape the direction of the program.
Radio jan-jan se juda hua hai aur radio ki bahut badi taakat hai. Communication ki reach और उसकी गहराई शायद रेडियो की बराबरी कोई नहीं कर सकता. ये मेरा उस समय से मेरे मन में भरा पड़ा है और उसकी ताकत का मैं अंदाज करता था. तो जब मैं प्रधानमंत्री बना तो सबसे ताकतवर माध्यम की तरफ मेरा ध्यान जाना बहुत स्वाभाविक था. और जब मैंने मई 2014 में एक प्रधान सेवक के रूप में कार्यभार संभाला तो मेरे मन में इच्छा थी कि देश की एकता, हमारे भव्य इतिहास, उसका शौर्य, भारत की विविधताएं, हमारी सांस्कृतिक विविधताएं, हमारे समाज के रग रग में समाई हुई अच्छाइयां, लोगों का पुरुषार्थ, जज्बा, त्याग, तपस्या, इन सारी बातों को, भारत की यह कहानी जन जन तक पहुंचनी चाहिए।
मन की बात के माध्यम से बड़े पैमाने पर जन आंदोलनों को बढ़ावा मिला है। हैशटैग इंडिया पॉजिटिव को लेकर व्यापक चर्चा भी हुई है। यह हमारे देशवासियों के मन में बसी पॉजिटिविटी की भावना की, सकारात्मकता की भावना की भी झलक है। लोगों ने अपना यह अनुभव भी शेयर किया है कि मन की बात से वॉलेंटियरिज्म यानी स्वेच्छा से कुछ करने की भावना बढ़ी है। एक ऐसा बदलाव आया है जिसमें समाज की सेवा के लिए लोग बढ़ चढ़ करके आगे आ रहे हैं।
The Prime Minister also expressed concern over a decline in open communication between elders and youth in families. He said that the communication would be more effective if people accept instead of expect and discuss instead of dismiss.
Kabhi-kabhi hamare purvagrah hi samvad ke liye sabse bada sankat ban jate hain. Swikar, aswikar aur pratikriyaon ke bajaye किसी की बात को समझना मेरी प्राथमिकता रहती है। मेरा अनुभव रहा है कि ऐसे में सामने वाला भी हमें कन्विंस करने के लिए भांति भांति के तर्क या दबाव बनाने के बजाय हमारी वेवलेंथ पर आने का प्रयास करता है, इसलिए कम्युनिकेशन गैप खत्म हो जाता है। फिर एक प्रकार से उस विचार के साथ हम दोनों सहयात्री बन जाते हैं। दोनों में से पता ही नहीं चलता है कि कब और कैसे एक ने अपना विचार छोड़कर दूसरे का स्वीकार कर लिया है, ओन कर लिया है। आज के युवाओं की यही खूबी है कि वो ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं करेंगे जिस पर स्वयं उन्हें विश्वास नहीं हो, और जब वो किसी चीज पर विश्वास करते हैं तो फिर उसके लिए सब कुछ छोड़ छाड़ कर उसके पीछे लग जाते हैं।
And in breakfast news, we'll take a very short break here. We'll be right back with more news and updates. Don't go anywhere.
जब मेरी 10th तक काउंटिंग फिनिश हो गई, तब मुझे हताशा हुई कि ये ग्रेनेड नहीं फटा। अंदर उन्होंने रूम के अंदर उन्होंने टीयर गैस का शेल डाल दिया। उसके बाद सफोकेशन शुरू हो गया।
तो आपको खांसी आई होगी?
हाँ, मेरी आंखों से पूरा पानी बहने लगा। खांसी, जैसे ही मैं खांसा तो उनको लोकेशन का पता चल गया कि लोकेशन ये है, तो उन्होंने फिर से फायर शुरू कर दी। अब यहाँ से ज़िंदा जाना मुमकिन नहीं था किसी भी तरह से। कोई सिचुएशन ये नहीं कहती थी कि आप जिंदा दरवाजे तक पहुँच जाओगे, क्योंकि 4 टेररिस्ट उस रूम के अंदर हैं और AK-47 की फायर पावर एक कमांडो से बेहतर कोई नहीं जान सकता। तो मुझे कन्फर्म हो गया कि मेरी मौत निश्चित है। जब मौत निश्चित है तो क्यों ना कुछ करके जाएँ, क्यों ना कुछ अब देश के लिए जो बचा हुआ है 100%, जो मेरा अब तक मैंने 100% दिया है, तो अभी भी मैं अपना 100% दूँ।
देखिए 26/11 हमले पर हमारा खास कार्यक्रम ऑपरेशन ब्लैक टॉर्नेडो प्रवीण तेवतिया के साथ सोमवार शाम 5 बजे।
Welcome back after the break. Well, today marks the 10 years to the horrific terror attacks in Mumbai. On 26th of November 2008, Islamist militants from Pakistan unleashed a wave of violence across Mumbai that lasted 3 days, and 166 people were killed and hundreds more were injured. The attackers, who were armed with AK-47 assault rifles and hand grenades, belonged to Pakistan-based militant group Lashkar-e-Toiba. The Mumbai police force fought with valor despite losing its top men. These are the live visuals that we are getting you. Remember, it is the 10 years to the horrific terror attacks in Mumbai. These are the live visuals from Mumbai that we are getting you. Remember, on 26th of November in 2008, Islamist militants from Pakistan unleashed a wave of violence across Mumbai. And 10 terrorists from Pakistan-based Lashkar-e-Toiba unleashed a wave of violence in which 166 people were killed and hundreds more were injured. The attackers were armed with AK-47 assault rifles, hand grenades. The Mumbai police force fought with valor despite losing its top men. and paying tributes to the victims of the attack. President Ramnath Kovind said that his thoughts are with the families and individuals who suffered. The president also said that the country salutes those from the police and the security forces who made the supreme sacrifice that day. He said India remains honor-bound to securing justice and defeating terrorism. Meanwhile, Navy Chief Admiral Sunil Lamba has said that India is better prepared and better organized since the attack. He said this is due to a string of security measures, including a layered maritime surveillance. And the United States has announced a reward of $5 million for information on the perpetrators of the attack. The U.S. State Department's reward for justice said that the United States is committed to working with its international partners to identify and bring to justice those responsible for the 2008 Mumbai attacks. News from Jammu and Kashmir now, where six unidentified terrorists were killed in a fierce gun battle between terrorists and the security forces at Badkun village in South Kashmir's Shopian district on Sunday morning. Security forces launched a cordon and search operation in Badkun village on Saturday night on the basis of a specific input about the presence of terrorists in the area. An army jawan and a civilian were also killed in the gunfight. And the nation marks a Constitution Day today. This day in 1949, the Constituent Assembly of India adopted the Constitution of India. Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu on the occasion tweeted saying that it is now our utmost national obligation that we live earnestly by the letter and spirit of the Constitution in our personal and community life. He said we must uphold integrity in our personal and public life, have trust and honor in constitutional bodies and processes. The Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu and Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Sunday attended a dinner hosted by the Chief Justice of India on the eve of the Constitution Day today. Chief Justices and judges from Bangladesh, Myanmar, Thailand, Nepal and Bhutan also attended the event. And Prime Minister Modi also spoke about the significance of the day in the Mann Ki Baat address as well.
उन महान विभूतियों को याद करने का दिन जिन्होंने हमारा संविधान बनाया 26 नवंबर 1949 को हमारे संविधान को अपनाया गया था संविधान ड्राफ्ट करने के इस ऐतिहासिक कार्य को पूरा करने में संविधान सभा को 2 वर्ष 11 महीने और 17 दिन लगे कल्पना कीजिए 3 वर्ष के भीतर ही इन महान विभूतियों ने हमें इतना व्यापक और विस्तृत संविधान दिया इन्होंने जिस असाधारण गति से संविधान का निर्माण किया वो आज भी टाइम मैनेजमेंट और प्रोडक्टिविटी का एक उदाहरण है यह हमें भी अपने दायित्वों को रिकॉर्ड समय में पूरा करने के लिए प्रेरित करता है संविधान सभा देश की महान प्रतिभाओं का संगम थी उनमें से हर कोई अपने देश को एक ऐसा संविधान देने के लिए प्रतिबद्ध था जिससे भारत के लोग सशक्त हो गरीब से गरीब व्यक्ति भी समर्थ बने
Let's get you all the international news now. First up, news from Sri Lanka, where a political impasse is set to drag on longer after President Maithripala Sirisena said on Sunday that he would not reinstate Ranil Wickremesinghe as Prime Minister, even if he was able to prove his majority in Parliament. President Sirisena said that he replaced Wickremesinghe with former leader Mahinda Rajapaksa because of policy differences and a sharp rise in corruption. Sirisena said that he planned to appoint a commission to investigate corruption and malpractice under Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe's government. Remember, Sri Lanka faces a deepening political crisis with the newly appointed Rajapaksa government refusing to resign despite losing 2 confidence votes. Sirisena has refused to accept the outcome of the vote, saying that proper parliamentary procedure has not been followed. Sirisena dissolved a parliament and ordered elections to break the deadlock, but the Supreme Court ordered a suspension of that decree earlier this month as it hears petitions challenging the move as unconstitutional. A verdict is expected on 7th of December. An update on the Brexit deal. EU leaders have approved the agreement on the UK's withdrawal and future relations, insisting that it is the best and only deal possible. The EU officially endorsed the terms of the UK's withdrawal during a short meeting, bringing to an end negotiations which began in March 2017. After 20 months of negotiations, the 27 leaders gave the deal their blessing after less than an hour's discussion. They said that the deal, which needs to be approved by the UK Parliament now, paved the way for an orderly withdrawal. Theresa May said that the deal delivered for the British people and set the UK on course for a prosperous future. Remember, the UK is scheduled to leave the European Union on 29th of March 2019.
Good deal, sad deal, not the deal itself, but the Brexit is a sad moment for the European Union. And I want to say for Britain too. Future is, we will prove this. This is the best deal possible. This is the only deal possible. I'm convinced that those having to ratify this deal and in Westminster and in the European Parliament will have this in their minds when they are taking their individual decision.
On to the other top international story, Russia has fired on and seized three Ukrainian naval vessels off the Crimean Peninsula in a major escalation of tensions between the two countries. The gunboats and a tug were captured by Russian forces. A number of Ukrainian crew members were injured. Now, each country blames the other for the incident. The crisis began when Russia accused the Ukrainian ships of illegally entering its waters. The Russians then placed a tanker under a bridge in the Kerch Strait, the only access to the Sea of Azov, which is shared between the two countries. During a meeting of Ukraine's National Security and Defense Council, President Petro Poroshenko described the Russian actions as unprovoked and crazy. Now, Russia has requested an emergency meeting of the United Nations Security Council today to discuss the crisis. On the sports news now, Indian women cricket skipper Harmanpreet Kaur was named the captain of the ICC Women's World T20 11. Openers Smriti Mandhana and leg spinner Poonam Yadav were also selected for the tournament. Three players from England, two from Australia and one each from Pakistan, New Zealand and West Indies have also been named in the 11. All right, so ICC has named its team for the Women's World T20 11. And good news for India is that Harmanpreet Kaur, the Indian captain, has been named as the captain of the ICC Women's World T20 11. And more cricket news, India beat Australia by 6 wickets in the third and final T20 International at Sydney on Sunday and levelled the series 1-1. In reply to Australia's 164 for 6 in their stipulated 20 overs, India finished with 168 for 4. Skipper Virat Kohli top scored with 61 and remained unbeaten. Earlier, Rohit Sharma contributed 23 and Shikhar Dhawan 41. India bounced back after India hosts got off to a strong start. Kunal Pandya took 4 wickets while Kuldeep Yadav bagged 1. India now go into the 4 test series and 3 ODIs against the Kangaroos on a positive note. And that's it from me and my team in this edition of Breakfast News. Thanks for watching and have a great Monday ahead.